start or we will study about the significance of psi and psi square. Okay? It can also be known as application of Schrodinger wave equation to hydrogen atom. Right? As you all know that hydrogen contains only one electron, so it's a very smaller system. And we can find out that one electron's position using the Schrodinger wave equation. So here, probability of finding the electron in different regions is different. We all know this fact, right? Now, in Schrodinger's wave equation, the symbol psi represents the amplitude of the spherical wave. Okay, you need to make sure that what is the meaning of psi and what we understood by psi square, because it is the factor which will give us the idea about the position, or it will give us the idea about the significance here. So, for hydrogen atom, the Schrodinger's wave equation gives the wave function of the electron situated at the distance r. As you all know that hydrogen has only one electron and it has only one s orbital. Okay, so the electronic configuration of hydrogen can be written as 1s1. So only s with just a spherical shape, which has a spherical shape and it just over on a particular atomic nucleus. So to find out the particle, we have to know the distance, which is r, right? That is the distance from atomic nucleus to the particular electron which moves around that nucleus. You need to make sure that what you understand by r here, right? As we have taken a very smaller system here, we can write the equation like this: psi is equal to c1e minus c2r. Okay, now here psi is basically what we know, right? That is the wave function. Now c1 and c2 are the constants for our hydrogen atom. E is the charge on it and r is the distance from the atomic nucleus. So if we put all these values together, we will obtain psi, right? And depending upon that, we can get the idea about where our electron is in the nucleus, right? Which is spherical in shape. So I should say that this equation can be actually applied to the orbitals which are spherical in shape, or which moves, or the electrons which moves in the spherical wave or spherical shape. Okay, now let's begin with the next theory, another part of this chapter: type of orbitals. Till now what we have studied is the electrons, that what is the distance and how we can find out the position of the electron, right, etc. Now we will study about the orbitals. Why we have to study about the orbitals? To understand the chemical bonding, to understand the basic bonding between two different kinds of molecules or in atoms, we have to understand that what is an atomic orbital actually is, and what are the types of such kind of orbitals, because these orbitals are not actually involved in each and every kind of atom. It depends upon its electronic configuration that which orbital will be fulfilled or which will be filled with an electron, or which will take part in the chemical bonding. This is the significance that why we have to study the atomic orbitals, right? Let's move on to the next one. That is, what do you understand by atomic orbitals, right? So to understand that what is an atomic orbital, orbitals are the areas where the electron resides around the atomic nucleus. So the atomic orbitals are the areas which surrounds the atomic nucleus in which the electrons moves, or electron resides. It's a home of electrons. They generally positioned in different energy states depending upon the orbitals, right? Now let's see the types of orbitals. First one, S orbital. Next one, P orbital. After that we have D orbital, and last one, F orbital. Here S is the most nearest to the nucleus, to the any kind of atomic nucleus. After that, P orbital comes into existence, then D, and the last one is F. F is considered as at the highest distance from the atomic nucleus, or it is farthest from the atomic nucleus, right? Now let's see that how they looks actually. Here, as you can see, the S orbital has only one type. So it has a shape which is spherical, right? And the maximum number of electrons which can be filled into this is 2. The capacity is 2. After that we have P orbitals. So we can divide them into 3 different parts. Number 1, Px. Number 2, Py. Number 3, Pz. Now, the maximum number of electrons which are possible into this is 6. As 3 different types are there, 2 is the maximum capacity of single orbital. The maximum capacity of all those are 6. Okay? Now, let's move on to the next one, which is D orbitals. Right? Okay, so D orbitals has clover leaf shape. As we have seen that P has dumbbell shape, D has clover leaf shape. Can be divided into 5 different types. Number 1, DXY. Number 2, DXZ. Number 3, DYZ. Number 4, DX square minus Y square. And the last one, DZ square. Now, total 5 different kinds of orbitals are involved. So maximum number of electrons which are possible here are 10, 5 into 2. So maximum number of electrons are 10, not more than that can be possible. Now the last one, F orbital, which is most far, or which is far away from the atomic nucleus, can be divided into 7 different types. It has a very complex structure, or it has very complex shape, because it involves different kinds of orbitals or in different directions. So the maximum number of electrons which are possible is 14. 7 into 2, 14. Okay? It is most far, or it is farthest from the atomic nucleus. Now let's understood that how they combines together. They generally overlap with each other, or when they came nearer to each other, at that time the electronic transition occurs, right? Or the electron moves from one orbital to another orbital in order to form a molecule, in order to form a compound, in order to move, right? In order to form a chemical bond. So to understand how the chemical bond formation actually occurs, we have to understand that how and which kind of atomic orbital is involved here, right? As these atomic orbitals combine together to form the molecular orbitals, and the molecular orbitals are responsible to manufacture, or that which kind of bond will be present in our particular kind of complex. Next, we will see in our next session. Thank you so much, everyone.